name is Ryan Barrett. I'll be speaking at I.O. So imagine you're starting a startup or an open source project, and you're working with people who live in a bunch of different places. Everyone lives in a different place. But say you couldn't email with them, or IM, or talk on the phone. Say the only way you could communicate with them was flying to one of them, meet one-on-one. You could never get more than two of you in the same place at a time. So this is how we have to think when we design protocols for managing data and building products that run across data centers. It's no fun, but we still need to do it because we need our products to run even if any data center at any time falls into the ocean, or more likely has a power outage or has a fire. So this is what my talk is about. How can you write a product or develop a system that runs in the face of not only a single server or a few servers, but an entire data center going down at any time? We don't have any magic. We do have a few people who have invented protocols that deal with this kind of thing, though. One of the most interesting is Paxos. It's what we call a distributed consensus protocol, where without any single master, you can have a bunch of different entities, data centers, servers inside data centers, agree on something. So most people know that you need to replicate your data. At a minimum for safety, you need backups. If you do a write to one data center and it comes back and you immediately do a read that gets routed to another data center, if that data hasn't replicated from the original data center to the other one, you're kind of screwed, right? So you either need to block on it, but you don't want to block too much on too much replication, because then every action your user takes forever. So these kinds of trade-offs, these kinds of tensions are what makes this kind of problem interesting. I can't wait to talk more about that and share that with people both inside and outside the company. So look forward to seeing you at I.O.